There's a deer, looks, just walked out. Just walked out right now. Right in the shoulder, mate.
What we're about to do now is what I've been looking forward to more than anything this year.
Here it comes. He got it. Oh, yeah! The marlin fishing. Holy Russ, this is so good.
Fishing and hunting, or hunting and fishing, whichever way you want to put it, it really is part of the fabric of Kiwi life, being a Kiwi. You know, getting into the outdoors in New Zealand and getting some wild food from the land, the rivers, and the sea. And there's been more than just a few mishaps, misadventures, and epic yarns come from that pursuit of just getting out here and gathering some wild food. And right now, we've got rods and rifles in the back. We're in the most Kiwi of trucks in heartland New Zealand to do the most Kiwi of things. Get out here and bring home some food. Buckle in, this is going to be a good one. Oh, and look, right in front of us, right in front of us. Oh, right here. And here we are. This is home for the next couple of days. Base camp for adventure. Come on. Oh, and look, right in front of us, right in front of us.
Oh, well. Whenever you go hunting or fishing, there is no such thing as a sure thing, but early signs are good that we're going to come home with some venison. Right, let's go and have a yak to Russ and gear up and get into this. I shouldn't be so rude and introduce you to Russ. Local lad, well, local Thai happy, eh?
Yep, yeah.
Born and raised, keen outdoorsman, fly fisherman extraordinaire, fly tyer, hunter, and our guide for today. So what's the plan, Russ?
Oh, basically we'll go and hunt a big gully over the backy. We'll go and find a good bridge, sit down, do some glassing, and see what pops out.
Look, yeah. Oh, a couple of them bouncing through the tussock there. Animals are harmed in this episode. That's how we get our food. You know, this circle of life. So if you don't want to watch it, don't. How many have you seen, Russ?
10, but it's still early.
I've seen 2.
Have you?
And they were ones that you pointed me in the direction of.
Yeah, there's actually about 5 over there.
Yeah, no, I meant 5.
Once that sun starts to drop and it cools off, they'll just start popping out.
Tell you what, there's nothing like a trained eye, though.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yes. I know. Once you know what you're looking for.
Get a guide, honestly. It's all very well having all the gear and no idea, but Russ and loads of guides all around New Zealand, they will just make your trip for you, honestly. Be like when go out fishing, guys will say, I'll be like, oh, marlin. And they'll be like, where, what?
Yeah,
look at the swirl. It's like, to me, it's there.
Yeah. But once you know what you're looking for, there's a deer, looks, just walked out. Just walked out right now.
Yeah, Roger, I see it. I didn't even see that one with the naked eye. It's a hind too, eh?
Yeah.
It's just starting to see a few deer coming out here. I guess the thing we've got to contend with is this wind. They've got incredible smell, eyesight and hearing. So, you know, what? That's something they've got over us. So, to make up for our human failings, we use these. So basically we can see them and be far enough away that they can't see. There's like animals up here too, look. See that at the bottom of that slip? It just walked into the cover. And that was exactly what I was talking about. Those ones down there can't smell us. That one just got the wind and came down the slip and shot into cover.
There's a deer, looks, just walked out.
There they are.
Yep, and there's some on the side and some down through here. There's about 4 over there. I can only see one now.
No, there's 2 there. You can only see one, mate. You haven't got these eyeballs. See, I need one of these just so I can keep up with Russ. See, I'm compensating. You can see that one with the naked eye. So you can see there, we can use this to really zoom right in and identify what we're shooting at. And that one there is a hind. That's what we're after, the hinds.
Yep. Yeah. Meat animals.
Yeah. I mean, obviously the better meat animal, but the spike is basically the male. Anything with antlers, even though they're in velvet, could turn into a trophy, which we want to leave for the trophy hunters. We're here to fill the freezer, and that animal there that I've got tack sharp on my iPhone through this Swarovski spotting scope could be one that we're after. Feels like you can reach out and touch it. It's half a kilometre away. Oh, well. What do you reckon?
Grab that gun.
Oh, it's about to get real. It's not sightseeing anymore. It's not nature watch. It's fill the freezer time. I don't have to whisper anymore, do I? There's been a big bang. Yes. Thank you, Russ.
Easy peasy.
Oh, easy peasy when you're with the right guys, mate. Oh, man. Oh, I've done that a few times now, but still gets me every time.
That is gold. Have a look. You can see the projectile. You can see
There's the bullet. Oh, you can see the perfectly in the shoulder. You can see the projectile. Wow, man, there's some crazy glass in this thing. This is where Bella earns her keep. Nice little tasty one. That's our first kill. We're pretty happy about it. Now, it's probably important to remember that not to misconstrue that happiness and excitement with disrespect. It's natural to feel good. It's bred into us humans to feel good when we secure food, particularly amazing wild food like this. But we're going to pay ultimate respect to this animal by cleaning it up. We'll take the guts out here, and the whole lot's coming back with us to be eaten. Well, first part of the meat chopping. You do home deliveries, Russ?
Yeah, we can organise that.
Hey. Do you do a laundry service as well?
You're a little bit wet.
Oh, just a tad, mate. I think a little bit of it might have soaked through.
Yeah, it's not too bad. Oh, it's only small.
Oh, good, mate.
Go for another one.
So the only thing we just need to refine on that a little bit is who carries it at the end.
Well, you're already dirty now.
You've done this before, eh, Russ? It does taste a little bit better when it's got a story to go with it. You know, when you pull some Vinny out of the freezer at home, you always do it when your mates come over. And it's always the yarn of, you know, that animal that you went into the back blocks and got it. It tastes that much better, it really does. You know, it's all about at restaurants now, it's all about the food story that they go on about.
That's
mate,
right.
There's no better food story than the ones that you got yourself.
Organic too.
Organic, mate. Jeez, you're good at this thing. We moved maybe, I don't know, 50 metres from where we took the deer on the back and just around the corner here.
We're going to have to wait for it to walk out, but if we get set up, if it walks out and it's a hind, we can take it. If it's a stag or a spiker, we can just leave it and carry on.
Okay.
That's all ready to go.
Oh, I've got a reasonably clean chop.
Oh, yeah, no. You can take that.
Okay, I'll take it. No, that's... Yeah, I can't see a shoulder now. Flies can smell the blood on me. Oh, we're waiting for this deer. I'm getting mosquito, freaking sandfly bitten and fly blown. All part of the fun, eh?
Oh, we'll go find another one, eh?
We let that one go. I'm gonna get some bug spray on. But if I get enough bites, I might swell up and get some quads. I might sleep outside tonight, get enough bites, just get some definition. I'm starting to get the hang of this hunting thing. Not only can I spot deer, I can detect the signs. Like, I think there's some deer somewhere out here. Let's go get them. Yeah, I see a hind over there. Through the neck. Oh, look at them right here. So they've stopped there. There's some stop right here, look. Stop looking at us. You'll get those bastards. Two more deer, just like that. And look at this. They stop for a minute and look at this. You know, that's what hunting, fishing, getting into the outdoors does. Brings you to places like this. We just let the rifle off. There's no need for me to whisper. It's just,
yeah.
Doesn't feel right to, in the quiet and beauty out here, to be talking too much. Just look at all this.
Stunning, isn't it?
Man.
Fetch him. Good girl, good girl.
Reminds me of when I was 19. Got set loose in the pub. For some wires. South Auckland. At least I better find them. She got it?
Yeah.
When you look from up there, you think, oh, okay, the deer's down there, let's go grab it. But it can be pretty disorientating when you get down here. With all this low scrub, everything looks the same. Without Bella, it'll be half a day trying to find this deer. Would you want me to go up and get the bike and run it down?
And take it down here, and then we'll go back up and get that other one. By the time you do that, I'll chuck it on my back and carry it out down there.
Matt's Home Kill meat delivery service. Pick up for Mr. Russell Anderson.
That's the one.
What would you like with that back steaks rest into sausages, Craig says?
Yeah.
Certainly, sir.
So they were all around about 350, 370.
These ones have seen us. They're a long way away though, so hopefully they'll think they're safe.
Okay, I'm hot. Yeah, right in the middle of the shoulder. Good shot, man. Doing another one. There you go, it's a hind. It's a hit.
It was a hit, all right. Plenty of any now.
So they were all around about 350, 370.
370? Not bad, it's getting up there.
So they're out there. And a bit of breeze too, you know?
Yeah.
So that's why I got that Kestrel out, just because that wind's going to be funneling up here, so just to get a semi-reading to what to dial.
Yeah, that's what I would have done.
Yeah.
No idea, mate.
Especially when you're shooting like that.
I know, mate. All I do is just try and get steady, put the crosshairs where Russ tells me to, just carefully squeeze, try stay calm, and, you know, all of the calculations are done between Russ and his fancy scope. As you can see, pinpoint accuracy, 370 yards, just tipped it over.
Three of them.
One, two, three. Let's go venison picking.
Going to a harvest, eh? That's good shooting, Matt.
Thank you. Bit of a venison recovery. Tipped over. Got this without Russ looking. It's the first time I've actually done without someone there talking me through it. Or like a sheep or something that I've done on the farm with no one else watching. Doing the whole process.
Matt just shot a deer from over there. And it's all like this. I think it's 370 yards. Scrub's pretty high. And put Bella out. And found this deer. Tucked up in the scrub. No way you would have found it.
Yep, that's all of them. Right, we'll hang these buggers up.
get a couple more, and that should fill the freezer.
So this here is a meat safe. Basically, it's you can see they've picked a shady spot. So the air's naturally cool here anyway. Big soffit to create more shade and open mesh. It's important that you get a good seal around the door. It's flyproof, but the air flows through, so it's nice and cool in there. Not chilled, like chiller cool. But what a lot of people don't realise is that meat, when it's fresh, actually gets more tender when it's sitting or hanging in a cool environment, not a chilled environment, so it won't set and go, you know, too firm. And it can stay in here for a number of days, as long as the guts is out, if it's nice and cool. So, very handy thing to have right next to the hut, the old meat safe.
It's private land, baby. In no way is this like wild bush hunting, where you camp out in the bush for a week and get wet and cold, maybe see one animal. Yep, here we go, they've come around, like I said, look. Hang on, there's a red horn there.
At the moment, the deer that we want is not presenting a nice shot.
Just a little bit more.
Yeah, I know. Unless we can get a clean kill shot, I just won't take a shot.
Turn around.
Now?
Yep, when you're ready, squeeze it off.
Not getting up from that. More running, isn't it? Right here, right next to us. Dan,
leave
right
it,
here.
Leave it.
Dan, right here. Leave it. Holy shit. That's another one. It's a red, eh? Let's go and clean this thing up so you can carry it up, eh, Russ?
Ah, we can drop to that one.
A couple of beautiful hinds, great eating animals, and no better place to come and get some wild food. So not only am I grateful for the food, I'm grateful for the fact that it brought me out here to see a part of this beautiful country. If I can implore all New Zealanders to give something like this a go, get out, give it a crack, it's something else.
Straight in front of us, there's two grazing.
Right, you've got a bang stick this time.
You can shoot.
Nah, mate, you shoot it. I want to go out on 100%.
To the right, still moving right.
Oh, that's
his broadside now.
Ready?
Yep. Missed.
What the?
Too high. It's alright, I've got one for you.
Oh, you can't put that on national TV. Oh, I don't believe it.
Everyone's a champion when they reckon they can do it every time. Put a TV camera on a man, see what happens to him.
Well, that's the venue sorted.
You go catch some fish.
Yo. What we're about to do now is what I've been looking forward to more than anything this year.
Here it comes. He got it.
Oh, yeah! The marlin fishing. Oh, he got it. Away he goes.
Yep.
Boys, here he comes. And he goes. Holy Russ, this is so good.